cutting the red across into the top pocket, a very nice stroke. Cue ball coming round for the blue, which is on the centre spot, of course. And down it goes. Choice of several reds here. Joe calls for the rest. He's after the black, of course. Down it goes, a very nice stroke, particularly with the rest, one of the implements that all professionals detest. Black goes down, break now 14. Delightful little screw there to come back on the black ball. Yes, no hesitation. 22, cue ball coming round for another red into the opposite top pocket, and I would suggest a black to follow. Now he screwed back for the blue. Another tender stun shot to put himself on the red is... This time it will be a black to follow. Difficult position with the rest over a number of balls. There you can see how difficult the position is. Break now 29. And he slammed the black in and attempted to split the reds up. Split one or two of them around the table. One across the table into the center pocket. Disturbing Joe, come round, nice position on the black. This black, of course, will give him the half century. Deep screw, bring the cue ball back off the cushion for a red either into the centre or into the top. He's taking the one into the centre. Again with a stun shot, keep himself on the black and amongst the reds. Still in perfect position. One, two, three, four, five, six reds left, and this is the first break of the first frame. Break now 66. Across into the centre, and the pink this time. Seventy-three. Still five reds left. 74. Terrific amount of side there to come back for either the black or the pink. There you see the perfect position Joe has. It follows the red throw for the black. Break now, 88, and three reds left. He screwed down for the blue.
Ninety-four,
and he's not too badly placed for this second but last red. 95. And there we have a century on television. Long red here, not an easy stroke at all. Unlucky. Well, Joe's first visit to the table, he makes a break of 100.